Okay, so as I was talking about, that doesn't explain how the triplets got into being here with their grandfather and their niece and this lady, who was really not the brightest. Because they're all like, don't go for him, girl. Don't go for Kermit. And she did anyway. Everyone's like, stay away from him, he's bad news. She didn't care. Oh, look. Look, it's Victoria and Tommy. I don't know whose kid this is, though. I don't know which kid that is. Is this to some degree of some sort? I don't know whose degree that is. There's more pictures upstairs, too. Okay, I'll give you a tour of the house when I'm done. Anyway, these three. So, they knew that their mom, Beth, is going to die soon because she's obviously an elder. And obviously their father's already dead. And they were living in this big mansion that Dominic moved into with Kathy. And Kathy, she has a medical degree. She doesn't really, she's not exactly the most well-behaved person. And taking care of three kids by yourself isn't exactly what she wants to do or what anybody thinks is best for the three kids. So they said, well, you can go live with your grandfather and Sony, who is taking care of Casamina anyway, and Casamina can help out. And Casamina's really nice. She's family-oriented. She's a bit of a schmoozer, but she's absent-minded and averse to seal. Or whatever. She's musically inclined. So that's why they said, okay, the guardianship can go to Kermit and Sony. Even though nobody really trusts Kermit, he actually is the only one who showed up for weddings. Like, Cassidy, she would show up, and people would try to talk to her, and she'd be like, no, I'm too good for all of you. She wouldn't talk to any of them. But Kermit, who everybody hates, goes to every event, even when he's not invited, and he takes care of everyone, and he actually kind of does care about his grandchildren a lot, so whatever. I explain all of this more fully in my blog, but I want to try to get into these videos. So to go around the tour of the Mahali house, and kind of maybe the city a little bit, this is the grave sites, and it's kind of sad that they have a little graveyard in their backyard. These plants were destroyed by zombies, which were these two, which are not zombies, or they're just random people in our yard. I don't know. Whatever. Anyway, this is Pavana. That's the mom, Casamina's mom, whose head is floating right here. If you read the epitaph, it says, here lies Pavana, beloved mother and sister. Yeah. Who is this? Oh, Kevin. Beloved father and brother died of a broken heart because Pavana died first, and he died right after her. There's actually some really good pictures. I actually have some really good pictures of that here. I don't know if you could see it if I pull it up. I don't know. I have so much on my screen. Yeah. But anyway, there's a really good photo of Kevin begging the Grim Reaper. And this is a random zombie, I think, that just died on our yard. Yeah, here lies the zombie, re-dead, yellow or not. Yep. So that's our little graveyard. Back here, there used to be a wedding thing, but now with all the kids here, they turned it into a play place for the kids. Because the kids, keep in mind, there's a ghost on the slip and slide. It's Kevin! Kevin! He's on the slip and slide. Okay. Well, there you go, you guys. You can meet Kevin, who died of a broken heart. He's not so broken hearted now. Partying. Anyway, so yeah. The kids came from this house that had a whole playground in it, and it was huge, and now they all just sleep in one room. And even though it's the Mahali house, it's They all have to sleep in this one room because everybody put them up here. There's more pictures up here of babies and stuff. Laundry room, bathroom combo. But so then they were nice and put in a treehouse, even though we only have $10,000. Whatever. So Casimina, and I think she works. Does she work? I don't know. I'm trying to get her skills up because somehow it says that she has a degree, which I'm not even sure if she has it, but it says she graduated from a university with a communications degree. Well, I don't know how, but that's what it says she got. So I'm trying to make her a writer. I'm going to try to get money with that, too. I don't know. Okay, so that's Sony asleep in bed. I don't know where Kermit is. What's he doing? What is he doing? He slept like the dead, everyone. Because he's a vampire. He's just... Hey, this is Nicole. I know you guys don't understand that, but I understand that. I made her. She's part of my Hunger Games family that I made because I was like, hey, you guys can battle it out to the death. And I made it, but then I stopped that. But then I moved them in here so that we could have more, repopulate the town. Because obviously I had a whole bunch of vampires for a while and everyone was dying off. And so here she is. And she's nice and stuff. And here he is, like, eh. This painting was by Casimina, I think. No, not Casimina, Cassidy. Still here and unfinished. You think if you're a vampire, you could come back. What was I doing? I don't even know why he's here. Why did I send him here? Was he trying to get money? Was he trying to buy something? I don't know. Did I just want him out of the house? Oh, he's thirsty. Wow. Okay, well. Oh, never mind. Well. He can greet her. Yay. I would be afraid of him. If I was anyone, I would go and run in the other direction. Oh, she's talking. She doesn't look very happy in this picture. She's like, ugh. I don't want to listen to you, even though I look happy. On the inside, I'm dying. He's like, yay. I just got married. I wouldn't trust him. He has no loyalty. At all. That's what they all said, told her. Oh, she's pregnant, by the way, everyone. Yes, it is Kermit's child, before you go decide. You, maybe one or two viewers, decide that, oh no, who's she pregnant with? She's pregnant with Kermit. It's all good. She's good. She's a good person. Sim, whatever. Look at her hair. Oh yeah, that's right. She went and, because she came from a very conservative family, and she was always covered up and everything, and so she's kind of like, bad news for the family, but they all still love her anyway, and now she's kind of their only hope, because she took in all these kids. So, oh, she's a cook, too. She's a kitchen scullion. She's a level one. I don't know how she's in the world, she's just a level one. Look at her cooking skills.